A Change Is Gonna Come is a piece written by Sam Cooke, who was an icon in the civil rights movement. He was compelled to write this song after he suffered an injustice. He and his wife were turned away from a hotel due to the color of their skin. In this song, Sam Cooke expresses the belief that our world could be a better place. It is a message of new beginnings and of hope for better times to come.
The next piece we are going to perform is What About Us by Pink. While this song can be interpreted as a love song or a breakup song, in thinking about the lyrics, we saw it as a call to our leaders and representatives to keep us, the people, in the forefront of their decision making and to act with integrity in the best interest of the public. With this song, we are given a voice to demand a more just and fair world for all people. We hope you enjoy this piece.
Searchlights we can see in the dark.
We are rockets pointed up at the stars.
We are billions of beautiful hearts.
And you sold us down the river too far.
What about us? What about all the times you said you had the answers? What about us? What about all the broken happy ever afters? What about us? What about all the plans that ended in disasters? What about love? What about trust? What about us? We are problems that want to be solved. We are children that need to be loved. We were willing, we came when you called. But many fooled us, enough is enough. Oh, what about us? What about all the times you said you had the answers? What about us? What about all the broken happy ever afters? What about us? What about all the plans that ended in disasters? Oh, what about love? What about trust? What about us? I don't want control, I want to let go.
Are you ready? I'll be ready.
'Cause now it's time to let them know.
We are ready, what about?
What about us? What about all the times you said you had the answers? What about us? What about all the broken happy ever afters? What about us?
Hello everyone, we hope you've been enjoying the Pops concert so far. We know that it's been a pretty hectic year, but that's why we think that this song fits perfectly.
Both literally and figuratively, this year's been cloudy. So it's about time that we say hello to Mr. Blue Sky.
As you know, this year's theme for the Pops concert is Ain't No Mountain High Enough. And what's the only thing higher than a mountain? The sky!
Without further ado, please welcome the concert singer seniors and Mr. Blue Sky.
Sun is shining in the sky, there ain't a cloud in sight. It stopped raining, everybody's in the play. And don't you know, it's a beautiful new day. Hey, running down the avenue, see how the sun shines brightly in the city.
Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why
we had to hide away for so long.
So long.
Where did we go wrong?
Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why
we had to hide away for so long.
So long.
Where did we go wrong?
Thank you.
celebration. Mr. Blue Sky's up there waiting.
And today is the day we've waited for. Oh.
Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why
you had to hide away for so long.
So long.
Why did we go wrong? Hey there, Mr. Blue, we're so pleased to be with you. Look around, see what to do. Everybody smiles at you. Hey there, Mr. Blue, we're so pleased to be with you. Look around, see what to do.
Blue Sky, please tell us why
you had to hide away for so long.
So long.
Why did we go wrong?
Hey there, Mr. Blue, we're so pleased to be with you. Look around, see what you do.
High Enough is a classic Motown song that encapsulates the experience of this year, in which we all had to overcome challenges and be there for one another. From learning to make music virtually, to building friendships in the virtual world, to readjusting to in-person school, we have had to climb the proverbial mountains to keep our choir going strong and to be able to make this performance happen today. We hope you enjoy our rendition of Ain't No Mountain High Enough and that it inspires you to go the extra mile for someone else.
Listen, baby, ain't no mountain high, ain't no valley.
Just call my name. Always are in a hurry. I don't need to worry.
'Cause maybe there ain't no mountain high enough. Ain't no valley low enough.
you free. I told you you could always count on me, babe. From that day on, I made a vow. I'll be there when you want me, some way, somehow.
'Cause maybe there ain't no mountain high enough. Ain't no valley low enough. Ain't no river wide enough to keep me from getting to you.
Waiting on the World to Change is a song by American singer-songwriter John Mayer, released in 2006.
The song won a Grammy at the 49th Grammy Awards.
In class, we got into a heated debate about what the lyrics of the song really mean.
It's obvious this song is expressing the powerlessness that we young people feel to change the world. It's expressing how we often feel misunderstood, and sometimes we're just frustrated with those who lead it. What can we do except wait for the world to change?
Yeah, cool story, bro. But you know, maybe the song is telling us that simply waiting for the world to change is not enough, and that we have to do something about it in whatever way we can.
Quiet down now. In an interview in 2007, John Mayer explained why he wrote this song. I wanted to start a debate, so I guess we got that part right.
As far as whether we got the music right, you'll be the judge of that. But luckily, the band worked pretty cohesively on that part.
Like with past numbers, the band listened to the original album tracks and reverse engineered every part.
Working together to recreate the whole song from scratch.
All misunderstood. They say we stand for nothing, and there's no way we ever could. Now we see everything that's going wrong with the world and those who lead it. We just feel like we don't have the means to rise above and beat it. So we keep waiting, waiting on the world to change. We keep on waiting, waiting on the world to change. It's hard to beat the system when we're standing at a distance. So we keep waiting, waiting on the world to change.
Now if we had the power to bring our neighbors some for war, they wouldn't ever miss the Christmas song. No more ribbons on their door. But when you trust your television, what you get is what you got. 'Cause when the only information, oh, they can bend it all they want. That's why I've been waiting. know the world to shame.
Harrison and performed by the Beatles in their record Abbey Road. George Harrison wrote this piece while avoiding a work meeting during the first sunny day after a long, cold, and lonely winter in England. One might say that we have been having a long, cold, and lonely year here in Southern California. But as some of us come back to campus, and some are also at home, as a community, we can enjoy time spent our classmates and teachers. We can now open the shutters and see the light at the end of the tunnel. We hope you enjoy this song and feel free to sing along if you know it.
Here comes the sun, and I say, a song composed by Randy Newman for the Disney movie Princess and the Frog. In the movie, Tiana dreams of opening a restaurant. She won't let anybody stop her from achieving her goal. So no matter what your goal is, whether it's opening a restaurant, whether it's learning a new skill, or just seeing your family, this song inspires you to work hard and never stop believing in your dreams. I present Almost There.
Mama, I don't have time for dancing.
That's just gonna have to wait a while.
Ain't got time for messing around, and it's not my style.
This old town can slow you down, people taking the easy way.
I know exactly where I'm going. I'm getting closer and closer every day.
And I'm almost there. I'm almost there. People down here think I'm crazy, but I don't care. Trials and tribulations, I've had my share. There ain't nothing gonna stop me now.
I remember Daddy told me fairy tales can come true,
but you gotta make them happen. It all depends on you.
So I work real hard each and every day, and things for sure are going my way. That's really what I do. Look out, boys, I'm coming through. And I'm almost there. I'm almost there.
Originally a traditional African-American spiritual that was given new life and repurposed as a freedom song during the Civil Rights Movement. The lyrics call for us to hold on and keep our eyes on the prize of freedom and justice for all. As we have been working towards a better world for this year, this song encourages us to walk hand in hand, though we are socially distant, and to persevere through tough times. Thank you.
Hold on, you've got to hold on. Just keep your eyes on the prize and hold on. Though the one
Tracy Chapman captured the music world by storm in the late 80s when she unveiled her self-titled debut album. The album sold millions of copies and faced issues of racism, gender, and economic inequality head-on.
As a child, Chapman said, I always had a strong sense of social conditions. I guess it was because my mother was always talking about things with my sister and me.
You could say that this band took a little more creative license with this number.
Instead of focusing on recreating each original part, we added our own flavors, instruments, and musical phrases.
Yeah, you know. We jammed out on it.
Made the song our own. A cool factoid is that Tracy Chapman wrote this iconic hit when she was just 16 years old.
This song is a powerful reminder that young voices matter, and all of us can and need to be part of creating a more just and peaceful world. Because let's face it, we've still got a lot of work to do.
True, but hold on. In the spirit of justice, let's be inclusive, friends. Old voices, older voices matter as well. And as you will see, we got some help from an older generation on this number.
Right. Anyway, guys, let's do this. Because, folks, what we're talking about is, well, we're talking about a revolution.
Take what's there.